We have been investigating about the karmic activities in our previous satsangs. This satsang is fourth in the series. The satsangs were coming under the title "The Laws of Karma Rule Everything, Including Self-Realization." Can one see that one's mind is filled with audio-video cluster of thoughts made up of images about oneself and the world around him? Does not one wake up only with these thought patterns from the deep sleep state? It is as if these thought patterns wait for one to wake up from deep sleep as a physical body attached with a particular name to that body, waiting to pounce on him, own him, to be him and to live as himself. How is that one is made to think mechanically, identifying with the thinking process itself? We are as if we are the thoughts. We have merged ourselves with thoughts. It's like an automatic machine being switched on when one wakes up from the deep sleep and switched off by some controls when one falls asleep. We know for a machine, an operator of the machine controls its operation using the switch controls. Here, in a man, what is it that controls these thought patterns? Who is the controller? At any moment, we have taken up ourselves as that body, and the thinking is going on happening. Moods are going on changing. Under whose control this thinking machinery or the mind is? Who is the creator of all these thoughts in one? So in the computer, when I want to work on the computer, I switch on the computer, click on a particular website or a program, work on it, close the program and shut it down. The software programs in the computer are already predefined, created with certain parameters. One uses a particular program within those predefined parameters. One cannot do anything apart from it. There are enough sufficient parameters are there to navigate, to do anything according to the program. And the program is already a set one. The programmer one human mind has programmed it and he has put into use, that is being used by one and all, be a company, group of persons, professionals. The usage of it is already defined by the parameters of the particular program. Just like a human mind, the computer also has different functions. Take for example, the cursor, it functions like a human intellect. A human intellect always got in the act of deciding between pairs of opposites, whether to do a thing or not to do a thing, whether to accept or reject, whether to go or should not go. Anything under the sky, whenever the mind is woken up from deep sleep, it is involved in these pairs of opposites always. Certain values already that have got registered is maneuvering the intellect's way of functioning. A particular software program in a computer also is like a particular thought pattern that arises in one at a given moment. Then in the computer, we have lot of link connections. If you click a link, you are shown another new page according to the context you want to see. So the different links that connect the program to various new pages are like different thought patterns according to the change of moods in one, which again get correlated with different other sets of thought patterns one lives with in one's moment to moment life of his waking state. These are all happening only when we are awake, when we are living out our life in the waking state. One is goaded, one is driven by something like a program in the computer throughout the waking state. And the shutting down of the computer, we do it voluntarily. We close the computer. Similarly here also, until one is totally worn out, withered, tired, after hunting throughout the waking state using one's mind, intellect and all the subtle functions, the thoughts are also tired, making that individual toss between all the things of life. And what happens? He is not falling asleep. He is enveloped by sleep. No more he is allowed to think or function in the body as one individual. This is what is our mind. Is it not like a programmed computer? Is it not similar to that? After all, again, who has invented the computer? Again, a human mind has invented it. Now come to our waking state life. What is this life? The day-to-day living. Waking state of every one of us. Does it not resemble like a computer's function? Have you ever observed how one wakes up from the deep sleep state? In ourselves too, thought patterns that move in the mind wake up one from the deep sleep, envelop him, and throughout the waking state control him. It is not our physical sensations or the physical body movements that wake up one, as if like a dead man we are fast asleep. And even the body sensations, they happen and go without bringing the mind in that individual to wake him up. So the feelings or the sensations of the physical body that creep in are also noticed only by the mind, the thinking process. The thinking process only links the one supreme intelligence or the awareness and the other side, the totally inert thing, our body, the physical body. And the link is the thinking. Through thinking only, the individual arises. Also, the whole world, whole cosmos, according to one's registrations or values one hold about that cosmos. Cosmos or relationships, everything. So, one can realize this fact that the medium for one's living is through mind only, through thoughts or images only. From where do these thoughts, sensations, feelings, images about one's own self, the remembrances of the experiences and also the experiencers arise? Do they arise from nowhere? Or do they arise from nothingness? How come a thing or an object can come out of nothingness? Can one see all these things and ask these questions? Where does it lead one? While asking these questions, one is again led to a most basic, the fundamental question directly connected to one's daily existence. What is that question? A past-like state one undergoes in one's everyday life. What is that state? Deep sleep. What is the nature of that? What is the nature of one's deep sleep state? From the outside, that is after waking up or getting up, we can say one or the other thing about it. But what actually is the deep sleep state? What is its nature? During waking state also, from where do these thought patterns arise? one is under different moods. The moods are going on changing in one. At one moment, a sort of irritability, irritations. Another moment, a joy or some sort of a happy moment. And another moment, some agitation, some expectation. At another moment, some past experience, remembrance. With the experience, one tries to relive that past. It may be of any type. So according to the experience, one's mood is again changed. So the moods are constantly changed. And again, moods bring to one's surface mind, new thought patterns. So everything goes on changing within. And we need not say, scientifically it is a proven fact, that the whole cosmos is under flux, constantly under change. From the subatomic level, the energy level, forces level to the grossest things, the physical things. So, at a given moment, a moment ago, a mind which was actually nothing, unoccupied by anything at all during the waking state, that unoccupied state, has it produced these thoughts now? The empty space. Some moments ago, I did not have anything at all in me, nothing within, no thoughts. I was totally unoccupied, no influences, nothing. And suddenly, in a moment, thoughts arise. Has that state, that empty state, unoccupied mind or unoccupied center, has it produced these thoughts? No. Watch it carefully, sirs. One fact we are able to see through all this, that thoughts exist timelessly, always. Maybe in some other form, deep down, deep under the mind, deep beneath the mind. Like in a seed, the complete, the past trees, not only the particular lineage of trees. If it's a mango tree, not only the tree, the past trees, the trees which are all around those past trees, existed around those past trees throughout the earth. Does a thing live isolatedly? It is interrelated, powerfully interrelated, is it not? So in the same way, the complete past trees, in a seed, only these past trees, the seed which is being held in my hand, in my palm, if it's planted, does it not contain the complete future trees? Not only this particular tree, the trees that are going to come, the whole nature, is it not hidden Does not one see this as a fact? Can one see this as a fact? At this moment, similarly, in an individual also, one human being, does he not represent the whole of the past, not only his ancestors? The whole of humanity, in what way one differs? By name alone, that particular features in the body. What about the psychology? Do we not share almost the same kind of moods and feelings throughout our waking state? For breathing, do we not share one common air, the element? So during the waking state, those thoughts that are to arise are actually waiting in queue for everyone, piled up to get expressed. The fact is, one never exists without thoughts, without thinking, during waking state especially. And the other state is dream state, that we will see later on. Always with thoughts. Only thing is, some of them have not come to the surface and others have become conscious. Those thoughts that are hidden, not expressed yet, they call it as unconscious, the opposite of conscious, that's all. We are not able to name a separate unique name. We are not able to give it to it. That's why they have used the opposite of this one. We are now conscious as if I am thinking, I am wanting, I am desiring, I am planning, I am doing, I am irritated, I am tolerant, I am good. All these things, the identifications. This I am is basically made up of the feeling of the body of one. That beneath the thought, under the thought, thought is only used as a cover by one. Basically, that is what they call it as ego. That underlying feeling throughout waking state, what is it with which one is attached? One actually has taken oneself unconsciously without a bit of investigation, a bit of inquiry, a bit of probe. So this is what is happening in our moment-to-moment living. Some of them are hidden, yet to get expressed as unconscious, and already what we are living with have come into conscious activity. One has become conscious about it. It is not he has become conscious. He lives through those thoughts. So which is actually driving one in this way? They have grossly, holistically termed it that particular feeling has tendencies. As tendencies. Suppose a thick forest think of a thick forest. And people, it so happened, it is very near to your village. And there is a waterfall or water source in the deep forest. And the forest is thick also. Suppose the people of this village, their water sources are dried up. And they have come to know about this water source. And they started finding the way to reach that place through this thick forest. As people use a particular path, by and by, regularly, frequently, ferrying water from that spot to the village, what happens? A track is getting set. That is, what is the actual happening by way of tendencies? The word tendencies actually means, a tendency actually means inclined towards, to attend, ready to attend, giving a particular inclined orientation for a happening. So that kind of a thing, when a human mind has identified at the outset, at the very beginning, as if that is that location, a physical organism, and thoughts come handy to him, and he takes a course of living, values are getting formed, and those values are actually forming out of words, sentences, and conclusions, judgments, and all the rest of it. But what actually happening is, a tendency is formed. The tendencies never leave, not only one, not only that particular individual. It never goes away from the cosmos at all. What is the science behind it, sir? What is the theory or the definition that was given by Einstein for energy? Energy is equal to mc square. What does it mean? The moment matter takes the speed of light square, it becomes energy. That's all. If an object gains the speed of light square, not simply one time, it is square. What is the speed of light? 186,000 miles per second. If it is squared and an object gains this speed, what does it become? It becomes energy itself. And if the energy condenses, it becomes object. If it loses speed, that is the other side of it. This is what is happening. In the same way, here, why have we taken birth? Why are we born? Why have we taken these forms, calling ourselves by those names? The tendencies are unextinguished energies. They need expression. Their way of expression is nothing but through thinking. It is a science.
அக்கார்டிங் டு த டெண்டன்சிஸ் அக்கார்டிங் டு த காஸ் அண்ட் எஃபெக்ட்ஸ் தட் ஹாவ் டு கெட் எக்ஸ்பிரஸ்ட் த்ரூ தீஸ் டெண்டன்சிஸ் டேக் பர்த் டேக் எ ஃபார்ம் தட் ஃபிட்ஸ் ஃபார் தோஸ் டெண்டன்சிஸ் திஸ் இஸ் வாட் இஸ் ஒன்ஸ் பர்த் இஸ் மேட் அப் ஆஃப் So, these tendencies are hidden as like in a seed. So, put together both the hidden tendencies only express themselves as conscious living in one. So, they put together They create an individual and not otherwise at all. An individual is a product of the unconscious and the conscious, and the whole lot belongs to a complete past. What is that past? It may be a past since Big Bang or millions of years of existence. So, the effect which we see as our birth is like a child born out of a barren woman. That is, these conditionings, these registrations, these thought patterns. Temporarily, momentarily, throughout waking states, a center owns it up, reaps fruits of it, of every action, becoming responsible for those actions, assuming fundamentally he is the doer of those actions. This is what routinely happening in every one of us. But what does a human being really think? He says he is thinking. He thinks as if he is the thinker, the creator of thoughts. The thoughts that arise in him are thought about by him. Who is this him? Him is the identification as the body. The tendencies hidden has become the physical organism itself. That is why birth is happening. It's just like a magical display. We ourselves decide new forms to fit in and live through them. And to express through that form the hidden tendencies. Are we not carrying along this illusion that as if I am creating thoughts, I am the thinker? Let us also see what a dream state of an individual is. Dream state is totally not under one's control at all. In the dream states too, the pseudo center creates the dream. What is that pseudo center? A cumulative identifier with all the tendencies as a body. Sir, how does one write a program for computer? It is made up of different codes using different languages. Again, what are those codes? Essentially, they are formed out of 0 and 1, combination of 0 and 1.
in the human genome project also, the physical body consisting of billions and billions of cells, a physical human being's organism, the physical body, has it not been written thoroughly, even for the hair, the particular color of hair, the texture of hair, the thickness of hair of a particular person? Does not a different code exist? Those code, CGTA, these four letters, do they not contain this particular gene program that is written on a sheet of paper with different combinations of CGTA for a particular type of hair? So, volumes and volumes of data, millions of papers are used to write the map, the physical map, the physical biological map of the physical body as genes. Are they not codes? What is the wonder about a human mind? As if a separate individual, one wakes up, does he not really contain everything as a seed within him? We have only come to know what are these gene codes, the gene messages, the genome project, and we have written, we have deciphered, we have mapped a complete human body, dug out all the details. Even we are able to find how a disease happens in one, how one gets a disease. If any break in the code of a general pattern happens, immediately one is able to identify it and say, because of this break in a particular general pattern of the nail, one person's nail does not have a proper growth. Do we not able to find out the cause through this course? So here in an individual, who is the cause of complete these three states? Because of who these three states arise in one? So in the dream state, the pseudo center creates the dream. Hidden tendencies which do not find a chance to express themselves during waking state, they become dreams in one. That those tendencies which does not suit for gaining waking state expression becomes the subconscious. What is subconscious? A branch. Under the main subject, you have different chapters. In the same way, the one subject, the one individual, he mainly is lived by his thoughts as the main conscious thoughts throughout waking state. What happened? Some of them doesn't suit. They do not suit to get expressed during that waking state of a particular individual. What happens to them? They form when one becomes fast asleep, manifest as dreams in one. And how does a dream happen? It is not depending on the physical universe at all. It creates its own world.
If a person is trekking a forest, trekking a mountain, the forest is created within one. The minutest details are through sensory perception within the dream as an entity, as a physical body. Though he is not able to see his body, the minute feelings are happening in one as the dream. Does not dream happen this way? The whole world with the person who is undergoing the dream also being set in the dream, and one undergoes it without any choice. There is no alternative for any of us. Dreams envelop ourselves and dreaming is going on. And for the dreams to arise in one, what is the precondition? The background situation for the dream to arise should be like a complete blackout. That is, everything is shut down. Even in the computer, before it is totally closing off, what happens? The shutting down process will take some moments because the internally the programs will get properly arranged, and finally folder by folder, file by file, it will close everything and finally it gets shut down. In the same way, initially before dreaming, one is enveloped by deep sleep. Complete blackout. A pause. No existence, nothing. And suddenly, as if in a theater, how we see movie, all the doors are shut. No light is allowed inside the theater. Complete pitch dark. In front of the audience, the big screen. One is not even aware of one's own body. Who is sitting on either side? Who is the next person who is sitting or on other side? Who is sitting? Nothing is being known. One is aware of total darkness. Oneself, himself, not available, is not to be seen. Only the mind is in pitch dark, looking at the movie which is projected. Is it not essential for this complete shutdown? That is how the dream happens for all of us. And if it's a good dream, a nice dream, a pleasurable one, within the dream, how does one feel? He is so lost in that pleasurable feelings that one enjoys. He is wishing it to continue non-stop. Does not want to come out of it at all. This is a natural happening during dream. But suppose if it's a nightmarish dream, what happens? Only waking state has to come for one's rescue. Only by waking alone, his fear is avoided totally. His fright is removed. Is it not? How are all these things happening, sir? During the waking state itself, Why should the earth revolve on its axis like a machinery? Like a machine. It is revolving on its axis. It has a clear-cut orbit on which it revolves around the sun also. And there is a satellite for the earth, the moon, that is revolving around the earth. Without even a split second fault in their movements, all these planets, stars, the whole universe, galaxies, what are these activities? Are they not moving very precisely? A precision? What is this set? A magnificent set. Whose set is it? The already set up set called the universe or the world is waiting the moment one wakes up from deep sleep to confuse him. It confuses seriously because the precision, the change of seasons throughout the year, precisely the arising of sun every morning and the setting, the full moon and the blue moon having its own course. The oceans getting evaporated. Becoming as clouds, rain clouds throughout the earth. Raining, forming rivulets, rivers, tributaries, all finally again coming back to the ocean where they originated. What are all these activities? Whose mission is this? The whole big set which is called as cosmos. We have to see all these things, sir. Everything is, that's why the laws of karma, the heading, really rules. Really rules. So for a human being, he is leaving out the hidden tendencies. Hidden tendencies, cumulatively, the hidden tendencies, what is it? They have come to exist because of one's past experiences. Not only the experiences of yesterday, a week ago, a month ago, a year ago, a birth ago, millions of births ago. No experience goes unregistered. The whole cosmic play is going on here for what reason? A a churning. An authentic questioning. Has to happen somewhere in this cosmos. Especially such a authentic question can arise only from a matured human mind, matured intellect. For that, the whole cosmos creating these sets, just like for a movie, how they put up sets, creating a real situation like environment for an accident or a incident to happen. In the same way, stumbling upon everything, the human mind, at some point in time, when it becomes mature, for that matured intellect, this fundamental question arises. What are these things? Who am I here? What is this thinking machinery in me? Why does it make me to run helter-skelter? Why does it drive me? Why am I tossed between different moods? These tendencies with a center called an experiencer, in each of the tendency put together, always identifying himself, is leaning himself on the physical body, and he has taken that body as real. And when that is questioned, whose body is this? Who is looking at and who is talking about as if he is the owner of it, he is the possessor of that body? Who is he? Who am I experiencing through this body? What are these experiences? We have to really understand one fundamental thing, sir. The experiencer, not even the experiences are important. Who the experiencer in one is at a given moment. The experiencers are the real mischief makers. Collectively, all these experiencers holding in their womb innumerable experiences since millennia. They are associating themselves with innumerable physical bodies. In one birth, one body with millions of experiences. And that cumulative effect is what is called as ego, an isolation, a separation, identifying through the thinking mechanism with that particular location, that is the body, physical body. It is called by different names, ego, mind, individual, etc., etc. And going on taking continuously different births and deaths. And the physical body, the ego, which uses the physical body and the senses, and they work like slaves. The physical body is a slave under mind, the ego. Sense organs are slaves. Until the point one realizes all these as facts,
Sir, we are looking at all this very deeply as they unfold in every one of us. If you observe this closely enough, you can see it for yourself. So, throughout the globe, we as individuals are nothing but products of our hidden tendencies, unconscious drives. All the pairs of opposites, success, failures, prejudices, competition, comparison, dualities of all sorts, motives, pleasures, pain, isolation, sorrow, agony. This has been going on since millennia, since Big Bang. Is it not like a die that is cast in timelessness, eternity? This mechanical happenings that's coming in cyclical manner throughout millennia, a cause which is having its own effect, and again the effect becoming a cause for the successive effect. Do they not happen cyclically, eternally? What is this self-realization? What is this karma? In Sanskrit, this activity, the identification of the activity with one's body as the doer, as the listener, any kind of activity, the identification of the activity, particular activity, with one's physical body is the cause of all suffering. That assuming that the physical body originates the action and he is the doer of it and he is the thinker, never realizing out of the thought flow a center arises and says, I think this plan will work out, this plan will not work out, this is good for me, this is not good for me, this is good for us, this is good for you, this is not good for you, and all the rest of it. One main root wrong understanding has totally taken the whole humanity away. This is what in Sanskrit they have named it as karmic activities. So what can be realization? In the thought, in the womb of the thought, be it any thought, every thought is nothing but a reaction that is getting reflected in one's mind. That mind or consciousness is available at all places, at all times, ceaselessly, eternally, it never goes. By one identifying with it, that thought is me, thought is mine, thought is by me, thought is for me, I am the thought, I am the sinner, I am the seeker, I am the aggrieved, I am the sufferer, what not. All these are thoughts. If this identification as the thought through a fundamental
identity with that physical body where it happens. One thinks he is the physical location, he is that body as that location, and thoughts are happening within that physical body. Does it happen like that? If one probes, is there any self at all exists? Collectively, what we call myself, yourself, herself. What is this self? Does it exist? For functional life, for utilitarian value, for to do anything, one needs this self. One has to be the self to act. But fundamentally, does it exist? That is what the way of untying the karma also. Snapping that chain, the karmic chain, how to snap it? When I have a feeling in my waking state, I am the sufferer, I am lonely, I am aged, I am deserted, whatever be the kind of feeling, I am in despair. Whatever may be the kind of feeling, if to break that chain, the karmic chain, if one probes without passing that sentence, without thinking that sentence, who are you? Who is isolated? Who is the sufferer? Who is that? Can one look as it arises in one? This is the beginning, sir. This is the beginning of ending the mechanical activity called karmic activities. One becomes alive. It is not one. Aliveness occupies. We cannot even add another word, occupies one or occupies a location. One becomes everything. One becomes all the places. There is no one at all. The whole, he becomes a whole space. For that only, we have been discussing about bare attention. The moment the word bare attention is used, what does it say? What does it mean? It is not your attention, my attention, or the attention of a cat which is looking at a hole for a rat to come out to catch. It is not the attention of a directed attention of that. The moment one says bare attention, it is just like the empty space, being with empty space. Can one live like this? Reflect on all these things, sir. The real self, which is not the self, the psychological self, the psyche of an individual, nor the body, nor the physical body, nor the cosmic cosmos, this cosmos. There is one complete wholeness which is not somewhere away from us, away from this place, and away in time, some other time. Our deep sleep states simply every one of us are engulfed, engrossed in deep sleep. It envelops us. The deep sleep envelops us. Why should at all we pass, judge deep sleep state also with the waking mind? Non-existence or existence, beyond this existence or beyond non-existence, no words, no terminologies apply there. Why should this intellect in the waking state want to pass a conclusion and try to practice it as a method in waking state? See the state, the deep sleep state. Do not draw any conclusion. We existed. In spite of our psychological self, the individuality with its all its acquisitions, with all its values embedded, in spite of all this accumulation, in spite of a seizure, total non-existence of the psychology, we existed. What is that existence? The sleeping state, the sleep state, deep sleep state experience, does it differ . Is there any difference between your deep sleep and my deep sleep? There is no difference at all. All differences vanish. All differences are unreal. The identification with this body creates those differences during waking state. We will continue this satsang in our next session.